black grandmother raided. Here's some of the video.
Denver Police Department with a search warrant. You come to the door with your hands up.
Front row of the seat back. Do you have anything on you you're not supposed to?
Huh?
Do you have any guns or a knife? Or
no. Oh, no. Well,
come sit back here. We're going to tell you what's up.
So nobody else is in the house, man?
No, nobody else is in the house.
Okay, there's a, so they got a search warrant for your house, okay? There was some evidence that they believe is in the house. So I'm going to walk you over there, and we're going to talk to some detectives, okay? Once we can make some more announcements, just give me a minute and make double check that nobody else snuck in the house on you, okay?
Okay.
Snowblower.
Put up the picture of Miss Ruby Johnson. Miss Ruby Johnson, once again, 77 years of age. I'm a 41-year-old male. Having something like that happen at my home would have absolutely created significant anxiety for me. I cannot imagine what it did for her. 77 years of age. Let me give you the background. Denver PD SWAT arrived at Ruby Johnson's home to search her property. They had a warrant based on false or faulty information. A lawsuit has now been filed in county court last week. It claims the Denver grandmother, Ruby Johnson, was subjected to this full-on SWAT raid because a detective used a screenshot from the inaccurate Find My Phone app. Yeah, or Find My iPhone app. And then was able to get a judge to sign a warrant based on an app that tells you we could probably be wrong. The app says it. All right. Ms. Johnson, with the help of the ACLU Foundation. This is in Colorado, the ACLU of Colorado. They're now suing the detective responsible for an unspecified amount of damages as well as coverage for the attorney fees. Per the suit, Ms. Johnson experiences anxiety living alone as it is and is afraid to answer the door now. And she even assured officers she kept her doors locked all the time for that reason, because she has an anxiety issue. Let me give you details. Retired service postal worker, Ruby Johnson. 77 years of age, was home alone watching TV January 4th when she heard an air horn followed by a voice amplified by a speaker ordering all occupants of her home to walk out with their hands up. Dressed in a bathrobe and house slippers with a bonnet on her head, she walked out the front door of her home and was met by an armored truck. Marked vehicles, military-clad officers holding rifles, and even had a canine dog ready. Why did this happen? The officers were there to execute a warrant obtained by Detective Gary Stabb, who had been investigating a truck that was stolen on January 3rd that contained $4,000 in cash. A tactical rifle, 4 handguns, a revolver, 2 drones, and most importantly to the detective's investigation, an iPhone 11. During a phone interview with the truck's owner the morning after the truck was stolen, the detective was told that the iPhone's location had last been pinged at Johnson's home twice using Apple's Find My app before disappearing. Though the owner was unable to find the phone or the stolen truck himself when he drove by, He told the detective that he suspected it could be parked in the garage of the 77-year-old woman's home. All right, that's it, fellas. He said he thinks it's over here. Let's go ahead and get SWAT. Let's get guns. Let's get a dog. All right, let's get our armor. Damn it, did you even check to see who lived at the house? Did you just pull the deed? The woman worked for the post office for a whole adult life. Nobody questioned this. Nobody said, wait a minute, guys, wait. According to our investigation, there's a damn near 80-year-old woman inside of here. The detective used a screenshot of the phone's alleged location and the victim's claim that the Find My Phone app had been accurate enough to locate his devices within 5 feet of its location in the past, was able to obtain a warrant for the raid from a Denver County Court judge. Once again, the app tells you we could be wrong. The screenshot in question, let's put it up. That's the screenshot. It shows the stolen iPhone was not last seen on Johnson's property, but somewhere near her home and the homes of at least 6 others. So what really happened here? They made a determination as to which one of these homes they needed to raid. They did that. And then they said, oh, no. The app told us precisely where. No, did not. There's more. Apple's Find My app is not always clear on the exact location of a user's device. It instead offers an approximate location in these instances, as indicated by a radio article. Apple even recommends in its own legal process guidelines that law enforcement should request device locations through manufacturer and not the app. Johnson was placed in the back of a police car, okay? They detained her while they searched her property. Officers even destroyed some of her property, including a collectible doll and locks to her garage and shed, as well as standing on newly purchased furniture to search her attic. Now, if this grandmother is anything like my grandmother, the worst sin they committed was standing on that damn furniture, okay? Let's put up some of the destruction. This is so sad. This is so extreme. Look at this. A grandmother, 77 years old. After hours of searching, police found nothing incriminating and finally let her go. Hours, okay? No one apologized or explained the exact reason for the raid, according to the lawsuit. And Johnson says she was left physically and emotionally traumatized by the officers and their actions. Immediately following the raid, she spent the week at her daughter's home, who lived nearby, before spending the next 3 months with her son in Houston, Texas. She could not stand to go back there. Put up the picture of the chief. Chief Ron Thomas, Denver PD. Now, Chief, you came out of a black woman yourself. You have a black grandmother yourself. What are you gonna do about these cops? They violated every protocol. You see that clearly. Even Apple says, hell, they violated the very protocols we lay out for law enforcement. What are you gonna do, Chief? We'll continue to follow this story as the lawsuit develops. Ms. Dahl, legal ramifications here. What say you?
You know, first I want to say thank goodness she was safe, because as we saw with Breonna Taylor, you know, these affidavits can end very dangerously. Somebody's home, they're not expecting to be raided by police. It could be end very poorly. And you know, and the same thing happened with Breonna Taylor, is that bad information was included in the affidavit and the judge signed off on it. And I've talked about it, we've talked about this. You know, if I'm a lawyer and I'm going into court and I lie to the court, there will be consequences. I will be disbarred. If a police officer is essentially lying to the court and trying to get a search warrant, there are no consequences. I mean, sure, technically on the books there are, but they are definitely not being aggressively pursued. And I think that what's the point of having a judge sign off on a search warrant? It's because we know this is inherently dangerous and people have a right to privacy. So we give it this extra level of security. Let's have the judge sign off on it. But if the police officer is going to commit a fraud on the court and give misleading or an outright lie and commit perjury, we need to make that a really severe penalty. Otherwise, there's no point in getting a judge to sign off on it.
You make such a great point. If a lawyer lies, that lawyer is at risk of being disbarred, meaning no more professional lawyer for you. But if a cop does it, maybe not. All right, we'll continue to follow.